Hello and welcome to the episode 51 of What a Fab Day. I am your host, Simon Mas. Today's highlights include a concert at a prestigious hall, the first live performance on BBC Radio, and several studio sessions. On the 20th of February 1962, BBC issued a contract to record a Beatles performance for a slot on the radio programme Teenager's Turn. That night, the band performed their biggest concert to date at the Floral Hall in Southport. The venue was an actual theatre, with gold lame curtains and tiered seats. The concert was advertised as a rock and trad spectacular event to attract the largest crowd possible, but the only trad band was Chris Hamilton Jazzmen, whereas the rock bill featured the Beatles, Jerry and the Pacemakers, and Rory Storm and the Hurricanes. It was another example of the Beatles' improved engagements since Brian Epstein became their manager. In 1963, while producer George Martin was at the Abbey Road Studios to record a piano part for Misery and a piano and celeste part for Baby It's You, these latter two were discarded in the final mixdown of the song, the Beatles were somewhere else in London, and specifically at the Playhouse Theatre. Starting at 11:15 a.m., they rehearsed Love Me Do and Please Please Me, their two singles, for a live performance to be broadcast between 12:31 and 1:30 p.m. during BBC Radio's Parade of the Pops. After the show, their first live radio performance, the band drove back north for an evening engagement at the Swimming Baths in Doncaster, 160 miles away, about 260 kilometers. In his book, The Complete Beatles Chronicle, Beatles historian Mark Lewson wonders whether the 4 minutes 10 seconds of airtime the lads got were worth all this effort. Of course they were, and it's that kind of effort that helped making the Beatles the phenomenon that they would become in 1963. Talking about efforts, let me give you a quick reminder. If you're enjoying the show, please visit www.simonmas.com/support and see how you can help me to create the best music-related content for your pleasure. If a donation, no matter how small, is out of the question, perhaps you can still be fab and tell your friends about this podcast, or perhaps leave me a comment. On the 28th of February 1965, the Beatles were at the EMI Studios in Abbey Road for the 6th day straight. Between 11 and 12 noon, there was a mixing session, completing If You Got Trouble, Tell Me What You See, and You're Gonna Lose That Girl. Then, until 5:15 p.m, the band recorded two takes of That Means a Lot, a song that they did not complete. Unhappy with the recording, the Fabs tried a remake on the 30th of March, as we will see in episode 89 of What a Fab Day. Anyhow, between 5:15 and 6 p.m, another mono mixing session wrapped up the day's work, rounding up the work done on That Means a Lot and completing You've Got to Hide Your Love Away. The 11 mono mixes of the songs completed between the 15th of February and this day traveled with the Beatles to the Bahamas, ending up in the hands of film producer Walter Shenson and director Richard Lester. But we will talk about the Bahamas, help, and its filming in later episodes. Right now, it's time to move to 1967, when the Beatles continued working on Being for the Benefit of Mr. Kite. John Lennon had asked George Martin to create a circus atmosphere to serve as background for the song. Martin had tried to get a hold of a hand-operated steam organ to play background music for the middle section of the song, but he had been unsuccessful. Today, he realized that there was a cheaper and simpler shortcut to complete the task at hand. He acquired some old tapes of Calliope recordings of Sousa marches, the Calliope being a huge Victorian instrument operated by sending steam through locomotive whistles. Martin instructed engineer Geoff Emerick to slice up the tapes and mix them by throwing the pieces in the air. He was then to reassemble the tape at random. This was a task that took most of the 7 p.m. to 2:15 a.m. session today at EMI Studios, along with a rough mono mix of Good Morning, Good Morning. In 1968, Paul McCartney and Ringo Starr arrived in New Delhi, India, after a 20-hour flight from London. Their arrival was welcomed by cameramen and journalists assembled to hear the latest news about the band and broadcast them to the world. The press had become aware of the presence of the Beatles in India, and a low-profile arrival like John's and George's was impossible. Ringo and Paul met their assistant Mal Evans at the airport to be driven to Rishikesh, where they, along with John, George, and other pupils, would have studied transcendental meditation with Maharishi Mahesh Yogi. Ringo, though, was in pain after the inoculation injections, and they set off to find a hospital before actually going to Rishikesh. In 1969, the Beatles might have reconvened at the Apple Studios to rehearse for their next studio session, booked on the 22nd of February. BeatlesBible.com notices how some photographs in the book accompanying the Let It Be album in 1970 and the hardback book from the 2012 vinyl box set showed the band during a session that could not have taken place in January 1969, and indicate this as a possible date. While the focus of the session was rehearsing I Want You, She's So Heavy, the band might have re-recorded parts of Don't Let Me Down. In particular, John and Paul might have changed elements of their vocal parts, and John might have double-tracked his voice during the middle eight and the ending of the song. This is all speculation, as no documentation exists of this session, and it might have well happened at another date, but I will follow Beatles Bible guesswork here. Another couple of studio sessions conclude today's show, these ones taking place in 1970. They were both stereo mixing sessions for Sentimental Journey at the EMI Studios, held between 11 a.m. and 1 p.m. and between 2:30 and 6:45 p.m. Love is a Many Splendored Thing, Dream, Sentimental Journey, I'm a Fool to Care, Let the Rest of the World Go By, and Have I Told You Lately That I Love You were mixed and added to a tentative master tape with Night and Day, Stardust, and Blue Turning Grey Over You. Well, that's it for today. See you tomorrow for more Beatles history. For the moment, I wish you a good day and a fab continuation.
Simon Mas, music you love.